And so she took every single pill bottle, aspirin bottle, everything out of the bathroom and poured them all over the living room. And then she took all of this alcohol and she was like throwing it on the drapes. And I walked in, I said, "What are you doing?" She said, "I'm giving him what he wants."
Advice I ever got from my mother, and this has nothing to do with performing, but it just made me laugh so hard, and I hope you all have the same kind of peculiar sense of humor. She said, "When you go to a party, go into the ladies' bathroom and look in the medicine cabinet, and you'll know what kind of a party it's going to be."
When our mother was growing up, you really had to be above reproach. In fact, it was built into your contract to be above reproach. You could get fired for not giving the right, picture of yourself. So instead of not letting people do things that were bananas, people went ahead and did them, and the studios would bail them out, and then they would take a picture where they looked all perfect again. Now you get down to my time. And when I first started, it was all very sort of going a little bit against the rules. Cutting my hair when nobody else's hair was short. Wearing really short skirts. When Lorna, hit her teens, it was real kind of rebel stuff. But then, it was, why the hell do I have to say all this stuff and do it if I don't believe it? And people cheered that.
I was a stranger in the city.
My mother never made anything frightening or scary, even when it was frightening and scary for her. Everything was a game because she didn't want us to be frightened and scary, like when she didn't have any money and we did have to get out of hotels by putting all of our clothes on and running down the back way of hotels to get out from paying the bill.
I walk through the foggy streets alone.
I look back on it now, I see how wonderfully funny it was. You know, a little scary and very mysterious and very kind of grown up.
And that happened, but we weren't scared. I can imagine how scared she must have been.
A foggy day in London town.
Then you go through a period where you get a little bit older and you look back and you think, my God, what I went through as a child. Then you grow up a little bit more and you say, thank God I didn't go through worse. You know?
Did you have a normal life when you were being brought up, I mean, as a youngster?
I don't know. I have nothing to compare it to. You know what I mean? And I didn't know if it was normal or if it... Now I look back and it wasn't normal, but to me it was normal.
We traveled a lot. There were a lot of great highs and there were some pretty bad lows. But it was never boring.
Fly me to the moon.
When we lived here in Beverly Hills, it was a wonderful fantasy. I went to the park. I knew all the other children's nannies. My little best friend was Leslie Bogart, whose father was Humphrey Bogart, and mother was Lauren Bacall. But they were Leslie's mom and dad. We went to the Martin house, Dean Martin's house, and Frank Sinatra's house, and all of these peers of my mother. And yeah, it was privileged. It was a privileged childhood.
You are all I worship, all I long for and adore.
Everybody's mother in this city was somebody famous, or their father. So it wasn't anything to us till we started to move around.
Right.
And then it was like, well, what's wrong with us?
Yeah.
Why are we being singled out? But it's not her fault. It's not our fault. It's nobody's fault. It's just what we lived through.
I wouldn't have given up what I had for anything because I, at the ripe old age of 15, I was prepared to take on the world. I'd met every possible kind of person there is to meet, the nice people and the creepy people.
I didn't know who my mother was until I was about 7 or 8 years old. You know, I remember the very first time that I saw The Wizard of Oz and how it scared me because I had this very well-meaning nanny. My mom was in New York, and this very well-meaning nanny said to me, "Your mom's on TV, your mom's on TV." All of a sudden, I knew it was my mom because of the voice, but she was a child, and then there was this witch and these monkeys. Well, I went nuts. I got so scared, and then she called, and I was sobbing, and she said, "No, I'm in New York," and I said, "Yes, but the monkeys took you to New York." And she thought, "Oh, my God, what is going on?" She said, "I'll never let you watch that movie without me." And we never did.
She was our mom. It was everybody's icon. It was everybody's legend. We were the one with the lady in the terry cloth robe in the kitchen. I mean, I swear to God, she didn't open the refrigerator door and start singing.
I mean, the funniest reaction that I ever get when I'm walking on the street, somebody said, "Gee, I love your mother." And I said, "And I'm sure I'd love yours." And there was just this pause. I was just showing off for her.
You want people to behave decently, but when they don't, okay, when they don't behave decently and they do things that are not right and pretty despicable, especially against my sister or myself, we're going to come out swinging.
So you don't let them get away with it. You don't just turn the other cheek forever.
I can't do it with myself, but if they go after my mom, forget it. It did. And from that, they know. They know.
You have a really extraordinary, special feeling about your mother.
Of course. Who else is there to protect her? It's Lorna, Joe, and me. It never bothered her. It always bothered us. But she understood it for what it was. I try to do that, too. Except it does hurt my feelings. If they say I'm promiscuous when I'm not. You know? Or if they keep trying to make me, and they keep trying to make me interesting. I don't have to be, you know, a slut to be interesting. If somebody just talk to me and listen to me, I'm interesting enough, I think. Let me go out and do my work. Let me do what I do. Why make up things about me? I love my husband, I love my dressing room, I love my home, I love my dogs. Boring.
Why do you think there's so much fascination about you two? Why do people care?
Well, I think it's lovely if they do. But I don't really think they care that much. You know, I think that maybe they relate. Like if they see the two other sisters are fighting, they can go, "Well, they shouldn't do that because maybe something's happening in their life." So they can get out of themselves and sort of live through people. I've done that myself.
When I went through my divorce, they were chasing me down the street wanting to know if I was involved with another man, this, that, and the other, what was going on. And I have children, and I was concerned. But I thought to myself, this is the part of my life that being born into show business that I don't like. I got a phone call from a friend of mine one day, and they said to me, "Okay, if I tell you this, you better sit down." I said, "What?" "Your trash is on eBay." I said, "Excuse me?" They said, "You, Madonna, so-and-so, so-and-so, around your neighborhood." I said, "What do you mean my trash? I don't understand." They said, "Okay, you know how you take the trash to the garbage can? Somebody is going through your garbage and selling it on eBay." And I didn't know who was sicker, the person who went through the garbage or the person who would buy it.
Don't let anybody ever say anything against either one of us. Then you'll come up against a force you don't want to have to deal with. All we have to be is ourselves. That's all anybody has ever wanted us to be. And more than anything, that's all our mother ever wanted us to be, was ourselves, because we're just fine.